Welcome to A&M Awesome Animals.
Hello, everyone. Today we are traveling to Scotland and we will be talking about the Rough Collie. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel for future weekly videos. The Rough Collie is a long-coated dog breed of medium to large size that in its original form was a type of collie used and bred for herding sheep in Scotland. More recent breeding has focused on the collie as a show dog and also companion. Both rough and smooth collies are descended from a localized variety of herding dog originating in Scotland and Wales. The Scottish variety was a large, strong, aggressive dog bred to herd Highland sheep. Earlier dogs were also more sturdy in build and reportedly capable of covering up to 100 miles in one day. The Rough Collie, also known as the Long-Haired Collie, is a long-coated dog breed of medium to large size that in its original form was a type of collie used and bred for herding sheep in Scotland. A dog breed that's well known for herding and protecting abilities, Rough Collie dogs are described as strong, loyal, affectionate, responsive, and fast. Although they are a little less active than Border Collies, Rough Collies do need at least 45 to 60 minutes of outdoor activity every single day. Health problems such as collie eye anomaly, progressive retinal atrophy, bloat, epilepsy, skin problems, dermatomyositis, and gray collie syndrome that can affect the collie breed need significant funding if they're ever to be conquered. The size and weight varies among breed standards. Male collies can stand up to 22 to 26 inches at the shoulder, while females are 2 inches shorter. The males are usually in the weight range of 50 to 70 pounds, and the females are usually 5 to 10 pounds less. Their lifespan is about 14 to 16 years. Rough collies are known well for their beautiful coat. It's large, it's luxurious, and it tends to shed a lot. So be prepared for a bit or a lot of fur on your furniture. They're double coated, so the shedding lasts year round with an especially impressive uptake when they blow their coats in the spring and fall. The Rough Collie is a medium to large sized dog whose coat varies. They usually come in shades of sable and white, sometimes mahogany, blue merle, tricolored, and white. While they both have collie in their name and share some characteristics, collies and border collies are visually distinct. A border collie looks similar to a smooth-coated standard collie, but is more streamlined and generally smaller. The breed name comes from their location of origin, the border between Scotland and England. The name collie itself is thought by some to be a nod to the dog's original coal black coat filtered through the brogue of a Gaelic accent collie. When in working mode, the collie's tail hangs down between their back legs, although untucked. This keeps it out of the way of Wailard hooves should their livestock charges get a little feisty. Once the herd has been gathered and it's time to head in, however, the tail will go up as the dog guides both human master and animal flock back home safe. One of the more interesting collie fun facts has to do with the tip of their tail. Flare of white found at the end of both standard and border collie tails has a special nickname, the shepherd's lantern, as the bright white hue makes it easy to spot in low light conditions. Collies aren't silent, because many, even most collie owners, take the time to train and work their dogs. An out-of-control collie isn't a familiar sight. In fact, the standard collie's mild nature and personality traits have led some prospective owners to wonder if, like the Passenger breed, collies don't bark. They do in fact bark and are prone to doing so if they are bored, crated for an excessive period of time, or left alone to their devices while pets' parents are off to work. Potential collie owners should not mistake a calm and mentory demeanor for a trait that will last a lifetime. Providing these dogs with plenty of toys and engagement is the key to saving your furniture, giving your family peace and quiet, and establishing a bond with your collie. Like most herding breeds, rough collies have lots of energy to burn and require regular exercise. However, they are not as intense as some of their herding breed cousins and can be more mellow in the house. Rough collies are very clever and quick to learn. As soon as your rough collie puppy is old enough and has completed his course of vaccinations, take your pup to special puppy classes for general socialization and basic training. Keep your training methods consistent and reward-based. Collies love the attention they receive when performing simple tricks or competing in agility or herding competitions. Rough collies do best on high-quality dog food that's meat-based, preferably with no grain content. Many respected collie breeders and experts on the breed feel that collies should not be fed a diet that contains soy or corn. Because of the rough collie's risk of bloat, two or more small feeds per day are recommended, rather than one large feed. It's also been shown that the addition of a small amount of meat to the food can reduce the risk of bloat. In 1938, Lassie debuted in a short story called Lassie Come Home. In the Saturday Evening Post, Lassie went on to appear in the radio, film, and TV shows for over 75 years, and was included on Variety Magazine's list of top 100 icons of the century in 2005. In 1960, Lassie was awarded a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Queen Victoria was so struck by the working collie's capabilities when she watched the royal shepherds and their dogs working that she decided to keep collies for herself. From then on, collie grew in popularity. Breeders decided to buy up the best species from the farmers and created a breed that started its triumph around the world. It is well known that her Scottish sheepdogs were used as war and rescue dogs. The collie was very popular as a military rescue dog and messenger. During the war, the British used collies worldwide in military service, which triggered off the strong competition with the German shepherd dog. For patriotic reasons, only dogs of German origin were used in the military and police force purposes in Germany, resulting in the fact that the GS took over the collie's place as the working dog.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos.
See you guys next time. Goodbye!